Hi, I'm John, and I work on Yarnspinner. Yarnspinner is a friendly dialogue tool that makes it easy to add branching conversations and dialogue to games. In this video, I'll show you how to use Unity's localization package so that your player can see different translations of your game's dialogue. If you use Unity's localization system, then you can manage your localized game dialogue in the exact same way as any other localized content in your game. Yarnspinner will automatically fill your string tables with existing text in your yarn files, and then you can add additional translations for multiple languages. Today, I'm using Yarnspinner 2.3. If there's a more recent version of Yarnspinner available, please check the documentation at docs.yarnspinner.dev for the latest instructions. To start working with Unity localization, you'll first need to add the package to your game. If you don't already have it installed, here's how to add it. Open the window menu, choose Package Manager, change Packages to Unity Registry, find Localization in the list, and then install it. Once you've installed it, you'll need to set up your game's localization settings. Open the Edit menu and choose Project Settings, and then choose Localization. Unity will tell you that you need to create a localization settings asset, so go ahead and do that. Next, click Locale Generator and search for the locales that you want to use in your game. In this demo, the content that I'm using has two translations, English and Spanish, so I'll add those two locales. Save those files somewhere. Now that we've set up the locales for the project, we'll create a string table for the dialogue, which Yarnspinner will automatically add content to. Open the window menu and choose Asset Management, then Localization Tables. Click New Table Collection. Make it a string table collection and name it Dialogue. Leave all the project locales enabled, and next we'll make the Yarn project fill this new string table with lines of dialogue. Select the Yarn project and turn on Use Unity Localization System. Drag in that string table collection that you just made. And finally, double check that the project's base language is one of those locales that you created earlier, and then click Apply. When you open the string table again, you'll now see that it's filled with all of your game's lines in that base language. The next step is to add the translated lines for other languages. An easy way to do this is to export the string table to a file, add your translated lines, and then when it's ready, import it back in. So let's do that. I'll export this string table as a CSV and save it to the disk. I've already got my translated lines ready, so I'll paste those in. I'll then re-import the CSV file and the Spanish translations of my lines are now ready. Now that the string table and the project are all set up, the last step is to make the dialogue runner get its data from that string table. I'll select the dialogue runner in the scene, and I'll note that the dialogue runner is telling me that project is using Unity localization, so I'll need to add a Unity localized line provider. I'll go ahead and click the button to add it. I'll make the line provider use the string table that we set up. And we're all done. I'll play the game, and I'll see the game showing lines in my current locale, which is English. And then when I switch to Spanish, the lines now start showing up in Spanish. In this video, we set up a Yarn project to work with Unity localization. We filled the string table with content from the Yarn project in multiple languages, and we made the dialogue runner work with it. Today, we focused on just localizing line text, but Yarnspinner can also use the Unity localization system to localize assets like voiceover audio. We'll cover that in a future video. We hope you enjoy using Yarnspinner. Yarnspinner is supported by users just like you. If you like what we do, please consider supporting our Patreon. We also have a super friendly community on Discord, so please also consider joining that. If you'd like to learn more about Yarnspinner, here are some other videos you might like. I can't see them because I'm just recording this, but they're there. And they're great.